All right, now let's give your garden a fall tune-up.
Absolutely.
Because as everything dies and this cold air pushes in,
right,
with the help of event planner extraordinaire Sean O'Keefe, he's going to talk about what we should bring in. So, Jen, like, I have no idea.
As things die
in the garden, Sean, what do we bring in to talk about beautiful things?
There's so much fall color, and there's so many found objects, from pine cones to gourds, mm-hmm, to bits of sort of fungus that you can find lying around in the bottom of the trees.
Bring the fungus inside.
Right, but when I look at this stuff, and I see this at the grocery store all the time, they put these gourds out, and you see this stuff out in the yard.
And they look so nice.
What are the tips to make it look nice? Like, when you put together an arrangement like there,
it actually looks planned.
For me, it's going to look like a mess. So step us through this and tell me what to do.
Okay, so there's a math to it.
Okay.
There really is. And it's clusters of three or five.
Okay.
And using large bulbs or large flowers to anchor the floral design.
Okay. So I can pull the fungus if I kind of use it in a cluster. Okay.
And there's a little floral foam in here to help everything anchor into place.
And then you want to make sure it's wet too, correct?
That's correct.
So you are the floral foam guy? I mean, that because that's a key in having a successful thing there?
It's when you're doing loose, free-form arrangements, if you were doing them in large containers like that, you can sort of use the flower stalk to help anchor things in place. With these, the floral foam allows you to go sort of very unique and very specific, where you can anchor color in or add additional flowers and then build with height as you go along. So here's a little clipper for you,
rather than having me tear all the stems off.
Clipping this now. A lot of people clip the flowers in the very beginning, but they don't continue to do that. That's kind of crucial, right?
It is. When you bring flowers back into your house, the first thing you should do is process the flowers. By processing, I just basically mean removing the stems and the stalks and the auxiliary leaves that over time will start to go a little bad as you leave it. And we could do another couple of these little lovely
clusters.
Off to the side might be really great.
I was going to put it now.
Am I building something in general? If I want it to be on the table, do I want it to be symmetrical or asymmetrical? What's in right now?
Asymmetrical.
Okay, so you're saying keep it not from looking like a big lump.
That's correct.
Not too pretty
and you can also, like when you're working at home, it's very interesting to do one-sided arrangements, so you're not wasting the flowers. So this would go into a corner. You know what I mean? And then,
so you can actually spread your flower dollar out a little bit more by going ahead and just working on one side.
Correct.
If you're only going to show that side.
That's correct.
Okay.
Yeah. And then the other thing that I did to make all these things are a little bit easier. So they're all on little sticks.
And what about
now? Where do I get those sticks? Because I don't know anything about that. There's
most
a little wire
hobby store
to the stick.
Or something
really?
Like?
Hobby stores, floral design stores, floral student stores. Like, there's a great resource here in Atlanta with Hall's Floral Design. If you go there, you can do long classes or short classes that just help sort of bring the color in.
Right.
Like, this is a really beautiful fall flower.
I put that in there. It's great for height. Right?
But let's get another two of those.
Oh, okay.
And cut them at different heights.
I didn't know you could cut these.
Oh, absolutely.
Ooh.
So I'm just going to come in here and a little trim, and then another little trim there. And then they can be angled.
See, now with Sean, this is going to turn into be something nice. Otherwise, it would have been a lump of dead fungus.
And then there is some zinnia there, which is a local Atlanta flower.
Is this a zinnia?
Okay. That's a zinnia.
First try,
all right.
Got it.
As we continue to wrap that up, for more entertaining ideas from Sean, just go to SeanO'KeefeEvents.com. When we come back, Mike's got his eyes on a typhoon as it moves dangerously close to Japan. And they just had a volcanic eruption. So
I'm
we'll talk about
you
that.
Here.